Who's counting tonight is Washington State's country singer, songwriter, and recording artist, Dan Canyon. Welcome to 91.3 FM CJTR's Pickin' a Country, Dan.
Hi, Reg. Thanks for having me.
It's great to have you here, Dan, and I'm Reg Wilkie, and we want to welcome you, our listeners, who are tuned in on the radio at 91.3 on the FM band, or you may be listening at Sastel Max 806, Access 700, or anywhere in the world at www.cjtr.ca, and we want to thank you for tuning in tonight. CJTR is now accepting new show podcast applications. The submission deadline is Friday, February 19th at midnight. The CJTR Programming Committee is interested in hearing your unique ideas, including ideas that explore diverse perspectives and identities of local people, programs produced in languages other than English and French, creative approaches to audio production and broadcasting, as well as underheard music of all kinds. And due to the constraints of the COVID-19 pandemic, we are only accepting applications from those who are able to produce at home. Visit cjtr.ca/volunteer to read the full submission guideline. We are very delighted to have Washington State's Dan Canyon with us for this special pre-recorded edition of Pickin' a Country. And for the record, we are recording this show on February the 8th from our homes. I'm in Regina, and whereabouts are you, Dan?
I'm in Everett, Washington, which is about 25 miles north of Seattle on Puget Sound.
That's your home, is it?
It is now. I did not grow up here. I grew up in Eastern Washington, which is the Palouse country. If everyone has perhaps heard of that, it's just beautiful rolling hills of mostly wheat fields now, but it used to be a grassland where wild horses roamed.
Oh, right on. Well, I want to congratulate you and your band for nominations for the 2020 Academy of Western Artist Awards.
Well, thank you. It was a big surprise. We were not expecting it, and I have no idea who nominated us, but I do thank them because it's given us a rare opportunity to be heard around the world now. We are being played in 10 countries on 12 stations, and we're in 6 states on a 10 station.
Wow. The Dan Canyon Band is up for group album, and you have 2 songs that are up for Song of the Year, and one of them is Nothing's Too Good for a Cowboy, and the other one is Six Gun Philosophy, and we're going to hear both those songs tonight on the show. And this year's 25th AWA Awards will be an internet show on March the 30th, 2021.
Looking forward to that. Of course, we really don't think we'll win because we're the new kid on the block, so to speak. There's a lot of great country western artists who have long track records.
Tonight, we're going to be featuring some of Dan Canyon's original songs. Are you a cowboy, Dan?
I am not a real cowboy, but I do play one every chance I get. I grew up owning and riding horses in the Palouse, and it's only in the last few years since I retired from the airline industry that I have enough time and extra income to go over and continue my riding.
Oh, you worked in the airline industry.
I am. I'm a retiree from American Airlines.
So you could probably last through the wind.
I could lasso the wind, have many times.
Well, that brings us up to our first song of the night, titled "Can You Lasso the Wind?"
According to this song, you can't. Oh. You cannot lasso the wind, but you can try.
Well, it would depend on your type of lasso.
Right. Well, when you hear the song, you'll see the wind is actually a metaphor for the wild horses and their freedom.
I see.
I wrote this song, about the second cowboy song I wrote, and was inspired by literally driving over a hill and looking down onto an area of the northern Puget Sound. And in my mind, I thought, man, with a little exaggeration and imagination, that could be a valley with canyon walls and a water hole at one end. And it got me kind of thinking of that imagery. And I started writing this song sitting right there. This is what I came up with. It's actually one of my more popular ones.
Land no man has ever tamed, from sandstone cliffs to ancient seas. their battleground. Can you throw a saddle on the wind and ride off to the stars? They can feel the shaking of the earth and the sound of thunder and booms. Can you lasso the wind? Can you lasso the flame? Can you throw a bridle on a breeze and gather up the reins? Can you claim to tame a hurricane and cut it down to size? When the Mustang Stallion lifts his head and looks you in the eye, Mustang Mesa, few men have ever seen. Perhaps a remnant band of Indian ponies. Set your hat and draw tight your stampede stream.
Yippee-ki-yay, yippee-ki-yay-oh, I'm the roughest, toughest, meanest cowboy westerly.
Still Playing Cowboy by Dan Canyon here on 91.3 FM CJTR, Regina Community Radio. Tuned into the community, this is Picking a Country, and I'm your host, Reg Wilkie. And tell us the story behind this song, Still Playing Cowboy, Dan.
Still Playing Cowboy came about from a recording I was at, and we're listening to playbacks, and I commented to the engineer, I go, you know, here I am 40 years old, and I'm still playing cowboy. And he goes, you know, that'd be a great title for a song. And I go, maybe you're right. So I wrote it down, and then and later on, I sat down and I wrote this song based on just that one sentence.
Wow. Well, two great songs, Dan, to start the show off here tonight. And I'm going to find out a little bit about Dan Canyon. Whereabouts were you born, Dan?
I actually was born in Georgia, and that's where all my relatives are. But my dad took a job. He's a television engineer, and he took a job with WSU in Pullman, Washington, when I was a teenager.
Well, whereabouts in Georgia?
Decatur, Georgia, which is outside of Atlanta.
Decatur, suburb of Atlanta?
It is. It's its own town. We moved out to the Palouse in the eastern Washington when I was a teenager and got horses, and I just never went back. I love it out here.
Where all have you lived, Dan?
Well, mostly in eastern Washington. And back in the 80s, I decided to move to Seattle, where there's more music opportunities but less travel. And I came over to Seattle and settled down and joined a band and played for many years with them, which I still do. I have three other tribute bands, which are all the rage these days. We have a Bob Seger tribute band, a Bad Company tribute band, and a Neil Diamond tribute band. And these, wow, these all work real steady up until COVID, of course.
Well, but, good for you. How did you get started in music, Dan?
Well, when I first moved from Georgia to Eastern Washington, I had a very heavy accent, and I was kind of teased a little bit. And I just remember thinking that music was a great outlet to kind of set myself apart as not a novelty, so to speak, that I could just learn to play guitar and start a band, which I did in high school. And actually that high school band was together for 5 years, and we toured all over the place. And even while we were in college, we were on the road during the summers. And that was a great learning experience. In fact, I'm still friends with all those guys, and it's been so many years ago, but we're all good friends. And we even have a webpage where we share our memories and photographs.
Why did you start?
I just was attracted, maybe the Beatles, maybe. That might have been it. The Beatles triggered a lot of people to be musicians. And I just love music the way it made me feel, and I wanted to be a guitar player. So that's pretty much how it started. And I've just been doing it all my life. Even while I was with the airline, I kept my hand in, playing occasionally and recording.
What type of work did you do with the airline?
Well, I mainly did the ground crew, where the guys that run around unloading bags, and pushing the planes out, and stuff like that. Just I was not a pilot. Would not want to be a pilot. It's a lot of responsibility. It was a great job. You know, it paid for my house, and I got married, got two boys, and life has been really good because of that.
Let's get back to music. What instruments do you play, Dan?
Well, I'm mainly a guitar player most of my life. But a few years back, I picked up the bass guitar, and I've been playing bass in my tribute bands. I'm the bass player.
Okay. Do you remember the very first song that you ever sang?
That would be going back to high school, probably like age 14 or 15. And that would be something like House of the Rising Sun, probably, comes to mind.
Oh, yeah. Well, I think you and I are about the same age, and I know I sang that song back then, too. And
yeah.
And is there anybody else in your family, Dan, that sings?
My brother is quite involved in the karaoke business, but he does not sing professionally, just for fun.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I love singing karaoke, too.
And, you know, that's one thing I've never done is get up and sing karaoke.
Wow. What has your family done to encourage you along the way, Dan?
Well, I guess you could say they've never done anything to discourage me. My wife is totally supporting. She thinks I'm a great songwriter, and she loves my music, so I have her at my back, and I'm blessed.
What's not to love, eh?
Exactly. I'm blessed to have great band members who just really put their hearts into what we're doing.
Is there anybody listening tonight you might want to send a shout out to, Dan?
Shout out to my bandmates, if I may. Is Jim Kehoe is my bass player. Pete Frothingham is my steel guitar and lead guitar player. Johnny O is my other lead guitar player. And Paul Buck is my drummer. I've known some of these guys for decades, and some I've only known about 3 years, which when I put this band together.
Right on. Well, we've got another song in the queue here that you wrote. All these songs tonight are your own original work, yeah, aren't they? The next one is titled Those Years.
Well, let me tell you real quick how that came about. I'm friends with a mule trainer. She raises and trains mules in Missouri. And she posted a photo a few years back of an Argentinian mule. And his ears, I swear, they're like 18 inches long. They're just huge. And so I commented under the photo, those ears, with a big exclamation point. Well, she wrote me back. She goes, that would be a great title for a song. Do you mind if I send you some lyrics? So she sent me about 3 pages worth of lyrics. I pared it all down to what you hear on this song. She did the lyrics, and I arranged the lyrics and wrote the music and played on it.
Some folks say I'm crazy, just a good old-fashioned fool. They can't believe I sold my truck and bought myself a mule. No gas to buy, no oil to change, no license to renew. Should go out to lunch, we'll ride through the drive-thru. Those ears, those lovely ears, they always seem to know much more than me. Those ears, those lonesome ears, they take me where I want to go and bring me back to where I ought to be. Sit in traffic and I pay no parking fees. I'll stub my mule to any post or tie him to a tree. He seems to like my company and won't leave me alone. And with his built-in GPS, I know that I'll get home. Those ears, those lovely ears, they always seem to know much more than. Those lonesome ears, they take me where I want to go and bring me back to where I ought to be. You know the world looks better seen between those ears. They've even been the major cause of quite a few free beers. He's calculating, aggravating, ornery and sweet. No matter what his attitude, he keeps me on my feet. Those ears, those lovely ears, they always seem to know much more than me. Those ears, those lonesome ears, take me where I want to go and bring me back to where I ought to be. They've sized the situation up and always seem to be ahead of me. Those ears, those lovely ears, those ears, those lonesome.
Boys.
Nothing's Too Good for a Cowboy by Dan Canyon here on 91.3 FM CJTR Regina Community Radio, tuned into the community. This is Pickin' a Country, and I'm your host, Reg Wilkie. And Nothing's Too Good for a Cowboy is nominated for the 2020 AMA Award for Western Music Song of the Year. Another great song there, Dan.
Thank you, Reg. I'm very proud of this one. This one's gone through quite the evolution. It started out, when I originally wrote it, as a kind of a slow ballad. And I'd been playing it that way, but to get all the whole story told, it was like 6 minutes long, right? Mm-hmm. It's a little bit long. So I kept thinking about maybe I should speed it up, move the song along. So I kept playing with that idea. Finally, I went in, I had it where I wanted it. I went in and recorded it at the speed you hear it now. And this was actually kind of inspired by just thinking about my dad, the influence he had on me is, you know, growing up trying to be a man, and so I put all that feeling into a Western setting, basically.
Good for you. Whereabouts did Dan Canyon study music?
I'm just self-taught, starting in high school. It's just the desire to be a musician.
Well, good for you.
That's all it really takes. You know, it helps to go to college and study music, but I never did that.
And you never took lessons?
Well, you know, yeah, when I was like 14, I think I took a year or so of lessons from a guy, and he taught me a lot, you know.
Guitar lessons?
Yes, guitar lessons. Yep. And that gave me enough of a background to start a band. So that's what I did.
Good for you. What's the best thing would you say, Dan, about being an artist?
I think it's just the satisfaction of creating something that you're proud of. You never know where it's going to lead you. A year ago, I had no inkling that we'd be played in radio stations in England and Ireland and Germany and Australia. But here we are. We're being played around the world.
What would you say is the worst thing about being an artist?
It's hard to make a living just playing music. You know, the music industry has changed. You used to could sell records. Now the records are basically just promotional tools for your live performances. It's turned around backwards.
Yeah. Yeah, you're right. And now with COVID, it's really tough for artists to make a living.
Well, yeah, I'd hate to tell you how much money I've lost in the last year from all the gigs that were on the books and have been canceled.
Yeah, I can imagine. It's pretty bad. But hopefully, once this vaccine gets administered, we'll be back to normal here.
Well, the venues are optimistic. They are booking us. We do have gigs. Everybody that canceled last year has vowed to honor those contracts this year. So we're counting on that. My tribute bands are gathering in dates as I speak. Every day that something new comes in. So people are optimistic and they really want it to open up. So these gigs are in place. And if it happens, great. If not, they'll just be canceled and we'll just keep going.
Right. What kind of things does Dan Canyon like to do in his spare time?
Well, every chance I get, I go east of the mountains and I go horseback riding. I have lucky enough to have friends. One's a cattle rancher. One's just a frontiersman, and they have horses. They let me ride pretty much any time I wish. And I own all my own saddles and all my gear. And like I said, I grew up with horses, so I have quite the horse background, and I'm very comfortable with them. I actually have hooked up with a Bigfoot researcher, and I go out with him occasionally. And that's a lot of fun.
Did you ever find Bigfoot?
No, never have. I've never seen one. And, you know, I'm not 100% sure it exists, but, man, it just seems so likely. I just can't believe all these people are making these stories up.
I watched a show here just the other night about Bigfoot. I think it was on Vancouver Island they were looking for a Bigfoot.
Oh, yeah, Vancouver Island's famous for that. All British Columbia and Western Alberta, too.
Yeah. Well, you know, speaking of spare time, we have to take a short break, but don't go away. We're going to be back with more from our guest, Dan Canyon, right after these messages. You're listening to Picnic Country on 91.3 FM, CJTR, Regina Community Radio, tuned into the community. I'm your host, Reg Wilkie. And if you've just joined us, who's counting tonight is Washington State's country singer-songwriter and recording artist, Dan Canyon. Which artist would you say have inspired Dan Canyon the most?
As far as Dan Canyon goes, it would have to be the Sons of the Pioneers and Bob Nolan in particular. I absolutely adore Bob and his songwriting. There's just nobody better. Big fan of Riders in the Sky because they're responsible for kind of continuing the whole cowboy music scene almost single-handedly. Although there's a lot of cowboy bands out there, there's not a lot that get a lot of recognition.
If you had a chance to open for any artist in the world, who would you pick?
The Sons would be great, but I doubt if they need an opening act.
Now, you mentioned that you were in Regina at one point, very briefly. Maybe just tell us that story.
Many years ago, my band, and this was not a country band, it's a rock and roll bar band. We got hired to drive all the way up to Prince Albert in Saskatchewan. And supply the back line, which is the PA and all the amplifiers and the drum kit for the Grassroots of all people. So we drove all the way up there and did that. And that was very successful. And the agency kept us in Canada for about 2 months. And we went from town to town. Well, at one point, our visas were running out because we were up there so long, longer than they initially planned. And we were playing in Swift Current, Saskatchewan. Which I know everybody knows where that is. We were playing every night. Back then, you played six nights a week, right? So we decided to charter a small airplane. So we go out to the airport, hired a pilot, flew to Regina. He waited while we ran in. Luckily, the office was there near the airport. Ran in, got our visas all renewed, got back in the airplane, and flew back to Swift Current in time to play that night.
Wow.
So that's I never played in Regina, though.
But you said you also played in Lloydminster.
Lloydminster and Humboldt and Winnipeg and Medicine Hat and Calgary, Edmonton.
Wow.
Lethbridge, man, all over.
So you've performed on many stages.
All my life. I took a bit of a hiatus the 22 years I was with American Airlines because I'm stuck here in town in Seattle. Before and after that, I've done a lot of traveling.
Well, that being said, if you had a chance to play on any stage in the world, which would you pick?
Boy, I don't guess I'm too picky. Just any place that enjoys good cowboy music. Down in Texas, maybe, somewhere down there.
We have a couple more songs.
Yeah.
This next one's titled By the Light from Western Stars.
I got the title from a Zane Grey book. His is By the Light of Western Stars. And this is mainly my attempt to write a song that the cowboys might sing to the cattle at night to get them to quiet down and go to sleep. And so that's what this is, just me trying to put the cows to sleep.
Give me some room, and I'm doing singing, 'cause I know the words, and I'm singing 'cause I wanna be heard. I'm singing pretty good tonight. I'm singing.
By Dan Canyon here on 91.3 FM CJTR Regina Community Radio. Tuned into the community, this is Picking a Country, and I'm your host, Reg Welkian. Did you write this song for someone special, Dan?
Well, the first line is reference to my wife. I'm dreaming of you in my arms, I'm dreaming of life on the farm. Because that's our goal. As soon as she retires, we'll sell the house and move back to Eastern Washington on a plot of land. That is the plan. And have some horses. That's the goal. So anyway, this song started out as kind of a slow blues song. And the more I thought about it, I go, you know what? This has all the makings of a Western swing. And I don't have any Western swing songs in my repertoire. So let's do that. Just reworked it into what you just heard. It's kind of a fast-paced swing.
I like it.
Well, thank you.
Yeah. What would you say was the best advice ever given to Dan Canyon? And who gave it to you, Dan?
I'm not sure if I ever got any really best advice, other than I always come back to Ricky Nelson, who said, you can't please everybody, so you've got to please yourself. That is the best advice I could give any musician. And that is the advice I have held tight to, because there's a lot of people out there tell you what you ought to be doing. But if you're not happy with what you're doing, there's no point in it. So that's why I'm doing cowboy songs. I decided to write about what I know, and to write about what I love, and that's what I've done. I write about cowboys and horses and the Old West, cattle drives, range wars, you name it. I try to touch it all.
Excellent. What advice would you give to an aspiring artist that may be listening to the show tonight?
Keep practicing. Practice every day. 30 minutes minimum, more if you can do it. Every day. Practice your musician skills. Practice your songwriting skills. And that just comes with repetition.
So tell me, did you always want a job where you could wear your cowboy hat?
In a sense, yeah. I'd love to have a job where I could always wear a cowboy hat. So that's what prompted this song. Somewhere along the line, I was thinking about that. I go, you know, I wonder if I could write a song about that. So there it is. I did.
And that's the title. I always did want a job where I could wear my cowboy hat.
Now, I always joke that song title's in the Guinness Book of World Records for the longest song title, because I could never figure out how to pare it down and still keep the sense of what it was about.
Yeah.
Within the band, we refer to it as the cowboy hat song, if we want to talk about it or play it.
I always did want a job where I could wear my cowboy hat. I never had much use for suits or sporty baseball cap. Let the sun rain, dogs, and cats. I always did want a job where I could wear my cowboy hat. Jump in my 18-wheeler, turn on the radio. The dashboard lights will guide me through the night. job or I could wear my cowboy hat. Out my window I see a road meant for me and people who've come for the show. Safe from the noose and ride off been low on my horse. My only real crime was drawing in time. The spurs are what gave him away. He had his gun out, my bullet spun him about. His blast ripped a hole in my sleeve. What made an outlaw? Six-gun philosophy. Shoot first, be quick on the draw. Wear your argument slung low upon your hip. Be ready to debate the final word when the voice of your six-gun is heard. Now the outfit I ride for wouldn't let a man die. They're loyal to all to one. And Sheriff Frank Poole was sure easy to fool when the boy somehow slipped me my guns. I fire and reload on the run. And the lessons I learned were ones that I earned. Just listen for the sound of the spurs. What made an outlaw me was the six-gun philosophy. The eyes are the window to the soul. For most men can't hide the fear they feel inside. Showdown's the final act to roll. Your philosophy takes its toll.
Six Gun Philosophy by Dan Canyon here on 91.3 FM CJTR, Regina Community Radio. Tuned into the community, this is Picking a Country. And I'm your host, Reg Wilkian. Six Gun Philosophy is nominated 2020 AMA Award Western Music Song.
It is. Big shout out to my steel guitar player who also plays slide guitar. He's the slide player you hear on that cut.
Uh huh.
He did a great job. Everybody just raves about that slide. And that me, that's probably why it's in the, he got nominated. It's so good. But that song is another one that was inspired from a book title, some pulp cowboy Western from the 40s called Six Gun Philosophy. And I would just always like that. So I thought about writing a song using that title. And this song kind of revisits a common theme I've touched on in other songs of the cowboy kind of forced into being an outlaw kind of against his will. You know, he didn't really, he's not a bad guy, just kind of got caught up in things and things just didn't work out. And he was pushed into a life of an outlaw.
Mm-hmm. So what can we expect from Dan Canyon down the road?
Well, we are currently in the studio. We go in at least once a week. I sometimes go in twice, do a stuff by myself, but at least once a week we're in the studio, and we've got four new songs coming out here in a few weeks. Strawberry Roan, which if people who are familiar with old cowboy songs, there's an old ballad from the 1800s called Strawberry Roan, which is about a horse. Well, I just taken that title and wrote a whole new song around it. And once again, this song was actually inspired by my wife.
Nice.
It's about a cowboy returning home from a long trip. And it's a long way to go, but he doesn't have any worries because he's riding his Strawberry Roan, which is a good horse to him.
So we'll have to play that one the next time we have you back on Picking a Country.
Oh, yeah. I think you'll like it. That one's a ballad. The second song we're recording is another one with a really long title. And this one is my attempt to write a whimsical Western swing song. And this is, my wife laughs at this title. She goes, it's called If I Could Love a Girl Like I Love My Horse. And it's all about a guy trying to find a girl that he could love as much as his horse. But it's, you know, kind of whimsical, but it's a cute little fast-paced, really fast-paced Western swing song, and I think people will enjoy it.
Right on.
And the last two we're working on, Guns of the Open Range, which is just a good straight-ahead cowboy rocker, all about a range war, with all the stuff that goes on within a range war. And then the last one we're working on is called Ride Hard for the Hills. And once again, this visits that outlaw forced into a life that he wasn't planning on. This fella just gets caught up with some outlaws who are being chased. And he doesn't have any choice but to ride with them. Otherwise, the posse's going to shoot him because they think he's one of them, right? So he just goes along and ends up joining the gang.
Well, I look forward to hearing those songs, Dan.
Well, thank you. I think you'll like them.
How can our listeners get a hold of you if they want to get a hold of you?
The easiest way is just to go on. You can actually just Google us, the band, the Dan Canyon Band. The Dan Canyon Band. And we're on Reverb Nation, which is a great independent music site. And you can listen to stuff for free there. And you can buy downloads if you want, but you're welcome to just listen. We're on SoundCloud, which is really popular with a lot of bands. We do have dancanyon.com, but the way the internet works these days, I don't spend much time there. We're on Facebook mostly, Dan Canyon Band here on Facebook. Uh-huh. For people who really get into us and really enjoy our music, we have the Dan Canyon Insiders Club, which is a closed group. And in that group, we share footage of recording sessions and songwriting sessions, rehearsals, behind the scenes. We do like a photo shoot. We have somebody filming all behind the scenes. So you get like you're in the band kind of thing. It's not.
That's a good idea.
Nobody can see that but insiders.
Right on. And,
I also, in the Insiders Club, I'll share a series I call Anatomy of a Song, where I kind of really, at a much greater length, explain how songs were inspired and recorded and, you know, just the minutiae on a certain song. And those are fun to do. I enjoy those a lot.
Right on. And, how did they become members of the Insiders Club?
All you got to do is ask. Just send a message through Facebook or dancanyon@mail.com. There's no shortage of getting the word to me, and I will just automatically put you right in there. There's no dues. It's all free. It's just us want to share with people who really are into it. Because not everybody is. But I've got about 80 members, and these are all people that asked to join. I never prompted anybody.
All right, on. Well, we're out of time, Dan.
Well, it was fun, Reg. It went by so fast.
And it did. On behalf of 91.3 FM CJTR, Regina Community Radio, and our listeners, we want to thank you, Dan Canyon.
My pleasure, Reg.
For sharing your music and stories with us tonight here on Picking a Country.
All right. Looking forward to talking to you again.
I am too. Good luck to you. Keep living your dreams and picking a country, Dan.
I intend to.
Tune in next Friday, same time, same channel, for another edition of Pickin' a Country. I'm Reg Wilkie. Thanks for listening. Have a great weekend. Stay safe and keep living your dreams and pickin' a country.